Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. Today we're going to talk about imaginary and complex numbers. So let's get our notes out, a pencil, and a calculator. Here we go. I don't write this slide down, okay? Next two slides you don't have to write down. Once upon a time, a man sat down to solve a quadratic equation. He's working it out. He subtracts 10 from both sides. He gets x squared equals negative 10. And then he takes the square root of both sides, and x equals. He types the square root of negative 10 into his calculator, and guess what happens? It comes out as an error. So he decides that he does not like this. There is no solution. He is not willing to accept that there's going to be no solution to this problem. So this is what he does. Since his calculator doesn't understand negative square roots, he develops a plan. He invents a new sort of number system. New types of numbers. So, imaginary numbers were born. So, ladies and gentlemen, we are now going to start talking about imaginary numbers. This has to be written in your notes. Imaginary numbers. Imaginary numbers are going to be represented by I. I equals the square root of negative 1. So anytime we get a square root of negative 1, we're going to write I instead, because we have a new set of imaginary numbers. Also, make sure you get this down. Anytime we take I squared, it's going to equal negative 1. Both of these are very, very important. So mark them, write them down, highlight them. Very important. I equals the square root of negative 1, and I squared equals negative 1. All right, here we go for some examples. You guys need to write down everything that's on these next three slides, all right? Here we go. How do I use I to rewrite square roots? So, here we go. Example number one, square root of negative 25. First thing we're going to do is we're going to break this down. We're going to say square root of negative 1, square root of 25. Because we now know that the square root of negative 1 is I. So we can put I for this. And we know the square root of 25 is a perfect square, so it is 5. The proper way that we're going to be writing this, ladies and gentlemen, numbers first. So it's going to be 5i. That is our answer. We can do the same thing for this next one. Square root of negative 6. Break it down. We have the square root of negative 1, square root of 6. We know the square root of negative 1 is I. Now, square root of 6, there's no perfect squares that go into 6, so we're just going to leave it as the square root of 6. Right here, this is our answer. I times the square root of 6. Last but not least, we're going to look at this one down here. First thing we're going to do is break it down. Negative 1, square root of 40. We know square root of negative 1 is now I. But square root of 40, we can break this down. It's not a perfect square. But we do know that the square root of 4 goes into 40. And 10. We break this down, we're going to get I square root of 40 is 2. And 10, we want to write our number first. So this is going to be written as 2i square roots of 10. That is how we're going to simplify this. We're getting rid of our negatives, and we're replacing it with these new numbers, imaginary numbers, so our i's. All right, a couple more like this. Rewrite this one. We're going to have 5 times the square root of negative 1 times the square root of 48. Break things down. 5 is going to stay the same. Times I. 48, we have greatest common factor that goes into 48 is going to be 16. And 16 times 3 equals 48. We're going to keep simplifying. So we have 5 times I. Square root of 16 is 4, the square root of 3. Now, this kind of looks like a little bit of a mess, so we're going to combine things that are the same. What is 5 times 4? We know this, it's 20. So we're gonna have 20 I square root of 3. There we go, that's gonna be our answer. That's our simplified answer, our imaginary number. Next one, we're going to take the square root of a fraction. All right, when we do this, the first thing we're gonna think about is rewriting this into two separate parts. We're gonna have the square root of negative, square root of negative 10 all over the square root of 3. Now, break this down. We know we're gonna have the square root of negative 1 times the square root of 10 all over the square root of 3. Now, here's our problem, ladies and gentlemen. We cannot have a square root on the bottom. So in order to get rid of it, we're going to multiply the bottom by the square root of 3 and the top by the square root of 3. When we do that, we're going to get, we know square root of negative 1 is I, so we're going to write I square root of 30 all over the square root of 3 times 3 is 9. Still have a square root, so we're going to simplify some more. I, we cannot write down the square root of 30. There's no perfect squares that go into it, so we're going to keep it as it is. Divided by, well, the square root of 9, that's a perfect square, we get 3. So our answer is 9 times the square root of 30 over 3. That's how we're going to be simplifying to make things in our new imaginary number. All right, I have 3 more examples for you guys. We're going to be able to simplify our complex numbers. So here's the first few examples. Here, distributive property. We're going to take I times 3 and I times I. We're going to get 3I plus I squared. Now, if we think back at the beginning, what we wrote down, we know that I squared equals negative 1. So we're going to get 3i minus 1. Now the proper way that we're going to be writing this, ladies and gentlemen, we're always going to put our numbers first. So we're going to have negative 1 plus 3i. That is going to be our simplified version of this. Alright, there we go. Moving on. Here we have 3 plus 2i plus the quantity 4 minus 6i. No, we are just adding these together, so we're going to combine like terms. 3 plus 4, just going to give us 7. Now we have 2i plus a negative 6i, so that's going to give us negative 4i. And that, ladies and gentlemen, that is our answer. That's all we're going to do for that one. We're just going to combine our like terms. All right, here we go. Last example for the day. This one, we're going to multiply 3i plus 6 times the quantity 4 minus 5i. So I'm going to take 3i times 4. I'm going to get 12i. Then I'm going to take 3i times negative 5i minus 15i squared. Now I'm going to take 6 times 4. So I'm going to get a plus 24. I'm going to take 6 times negative 5i, and I'm going to get negative 30i. Now we're going to combine like terms. So I have 12i, negative 30i. If I combine my like terms there, I'm going to get negative 18i. Minus 15. Now I squared means negative 1. So I'm going to take negative 15 times negative 1 plus 24. Negative 18i plus 15 plus 24. I can combine my like terms. 24 plus 15. And I'm going to get 39. We know we have to write our numbers first. So we have 39. Minus 18i. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is our solution. All right, that is all I have for you today. Thank you for watching, and I hope you guys have an absolutely fabulous day.